That's our hero's mum.
Typical suburban garden. 1944. Some of those old prams were very leaky.
I sort of wonder how all this translates into other countries because, you know, to us, or to me in particular, growing up in this period of the war, it's all very, very reminiscent. And that's why this film was kind of interesting to work on a different level, because it was recreating our childhood, which was certainly recreating my childhood, where
right.
I suffered, not in the way that you did from the war, but I was very much aware of it. I'm older than you, so, I was actually more aware of it, I think.
Right. Saying earlier that, you know, that a lot of these shots that Alan did were based on photographs of some
Robert Capa. He was a war photographer during the Second World War who did a lot of real photographs right up with the fighting men themselves. In fact, there's a famous set of photographs that he took during the D-Day landings when we landed on the coast of France. And he actually got on to the beach before everybody else and took shots of the soldiers coming out of the boats towards the beach. And the terrible story is that when he sent them to the lab in England, the lab assistant buggered them up. And there are just, I think, about, you know, a dozen or so that kind of survived in a very shaky form. So, of course, they become sort of icons. But I remember Alan saying he was basing some of those scenes on that.
Clever cut to Pink's hotel bedroom. Somewhere in North America.
Tom and Jerry on television. It's in Los Angeles, but it's not actually in Los Angeles.
No, it's actually in Pinewood, isn't it?
It's in Pinewood with a painted Los Angeles scene in the background. And to get this effect, I remember Alan suspended the camera over the swimming pool and just swung it so it was continually sort of swimming.
Yeah.
Filled the pool with red dye. This was momentarily the screaming head, which was used as the poster for the wall. So is this you? Sort of you?
Yeah, this is me. This is me. In my grandfather took me to the chapel of the Royal Fusiliers in the City of London when I was about that age, maybe a little younger than that, to look at the memorial to the dead from the Royal Fusiliers from the First and Second World Wars. And also there was a big roll of honour there, a big red book, and we sort of pored through the book and found my father's name in the book, and which is why this scene is in the movie. My mother wasn't there, and but it was the regimental chapel.
Mm-hmm.
I see he's got a model Lancaster, and I think he's wearing a General Service Medal and the Italy Star.
So it's really quite faithful to your story in a way, in many ways, isn't it? Although it's not you exactly.
Yeah.
And all this, I remember you telling me this was...
Well, funny enough, the only thing I took away after the film was finished was that plaque that was on the wall that you just see briefly and all that. I've got that in front of the hearth of one of the fires at home. I kept that as a keepsake.
Mm-hmm. I took some of the lamps from Pink's room because they were useful.
Well, very wise, you know. These days one can't be too careful.
Did you wear trousers like that, did you? Little short trousers?
I did. I had to wear short trousers until I was 14 years old.
Yeah, I'm afraid I was the same. My mother kept me.
Yeah, isn't that funny? Did you think there's something fundamental about the kinds of mothers who insist that you've hideously embarrassed by wearing short trousers until you're 14? I think everybody else has had long trousers since they were 12.
I think they're trying to keep their little boy as long as possible.
Yeah, do you think that's what makes people into artistes? Do you? I don't think
that's what makes people into artistes. It makes them perhaps repressed and...
It makes them seriously pissed off when they're 14 still wearing short trousers, doesn't it?
I don't know. Somebody...
Makes them go up with strange men, look. Let this be a warning to all those mothers out there. For God's sake, if he asks for jeans, let him have them. If you keep him in short grey flannel trousers, he's going to go off with strange blokes.
So, like, is that the stepfather now pushing him away? No,
that's just some strange...
Oh, that's right, he wants to play with the other little...
Yeah.
He wants to have a father.
He wants a father, he hasn't got one.
And he tries to adopt that.
Yeah.
Other boy's father.
Exactly.
Gets rejected, right.
Yeah. I don't think I ever did that. Not... I don't think... I don't know. No, I don't... I know I never did that. At that age, was I allowed to go off to the park on my own? Almost certainly.